Kuberas. Okay. As everybody knows here, we're going to have an outing for Kuberas. Many years ago, I used to commercial fish the stupid things. I would literally try to catch every damn one of them I could, and it didn't matter. Basically, what I've learned is that there's no perfect way, there's no right way, there are some wrong ways, but I'm going to talk to you about the way we were doing it and how we were catching the most of them. It wasn't always pretty, but the Kubera is not like mangroves, it's not like muttons, it's not like red snappers. It is a serious predator, unlike the other ones. The other ones come up and you eat a ballyhoo, who cares? A Kubera, when he eats a lobster, it is an event, because he doesn't just go up and mouth it, he just pounds it. We get him back and the lobster looked like he'd been just pounded with a hammer, just beat to death. There's nothing left other than the size of your thumb of a shell. We all know, you know, we're gonna use lobsters. You know, I've seen people hook them to tail, I've seen people hook them to head. I've tried it every which way. I've tried, you know, wringing them, keeping the tails, and putting the head down, thinking, oh, the smell will be better. No, I truly believe that live lobster, when he kicks that I think it drives that Kubera crazy. I've never seen it with my own eyes, but I've seen it so many times where you mark the fish over the top of the wreck, and on the way down, the lobster's going down and he gets woofed on the way down. And that's important to know, because if you're gonna fish the bottom, which I've done that too, and I've caught them on the bottom, you're gonna get stuck more. You will not get stuck fishing above the wreck. You know, you're just gonna drag your lobster or hang your lobster right there. My favorite way to do this is with a jig. This is an illegal rig for this club, okay? If you're looking to catch one, use this rig. If you're looking to get a club record, do not use this rig, okay? And the reason for it is that right there. That's illegal. Your treble hook is going to, it's just gonna end up in his eyeball, his face, you know, somewhere there. When they come up and they destroy their lobster, I've seen it where this thing's all the way down his throat, he's never gonna get it out. But I've also seen it where this thing's just hanging there and the treble hook's got him in the eyeball and you reel him up that way. So for your first one, do it this way. You know, this jig right here, I don't care if it's Austin's jig or Joe Blow's jig, this is done perfectly for what we need. You're gonna have a legal option, definitely use gloves, guys, because what's gonna happen is he's gonna be doing this, he's gonna go, pack, 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 you know, kick, 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 kick. You hear that? That squeaky noise? That's a magnet, these dumb things. I don't break the antennas off here. I'll snap them like halfway, okay? And the reason for that, they're gonna be doing this to you. And literally while you're trying to hook this thing, you're gonna get your arm scratched up. The swivel here, okay? You can use this same rig legally with a J hook, okay? On the treble here. Instead of using the treble, you're gonna use a J hook. Come right up inside here and come right up through his horns, okay, right through the face and right between those horns, and he's gonna be kicking the whole time. That's why you got to wear things, you don't want to kill him, okay? So now you've got this hook this way and he's gonna be kicking. He'll stay alive forever. You come up with your treble hook underneath him, okay, and you put that treble right up underneath here, anywhere in here. Okay, from if you put it down near the butthole, the anus, it stops him from wanting to kick too much because it's obviously painful for him. If you put it anywhere in this area here, even underneath there, okay, digging in there. See, what happens is when he comes up and bites this thing, he doesn't nibble. He is there to destroy it. The hook itself, okay, sticks up. That's not gonna be the hook you get him. It may get him down his throat because they eat it. You know, their mouth is this big around, guys, this big. So this is the one that's gonna get nasty with them, okay? This big old triple, quadruple strength treble doesn't come out, okay? If it goes in your arm, it's not coming out of you either. If the wreck's here, you're gonna mark, and we're talking about the screamer wreck and just about any of the wrecks, but mainly the screamer, they pod up on top. And the guys, my diver buddies have seen it, the Kuberas do a slow counterclockwise circle. And I don't know why, maybe they're swimming through sperm, I don't know, dropping eggs, I don't know. But if you're up here on the surface, you're gonna drop down the screamers about, I think what, 212?
Guys, you fish the screamers?
212 and 187.
Okay, so there's two pieces of it, one shallow, one deep, okay? And we'll talk about that shortly, but the main piece out there in the deeper is where there's more fish. That's how I've always done well. I've caught them on both, but that pod right there may be 100 fish, okay? If you drop your bait and you just let it sit there, when that live lobster sees that pod of fish, guess what? He's gonna start kicking. And when he does that, he gets whacked, and that's what you want. They'll run down, but when you're, you know, if you've got this commercial guy over here you know, you've got to kind of watch out for him. You know he's got his anchor line. His anchor line is going to be way out there. He's going to be way to the south. His stern will be pointing, you know, over the top of the wreck. He'll be pointing south. You need to make sure when you make a run, when you hook up, to get away from the sharks and get away from the other boats. When I hook them up here, it's a lot easier. You just gun away. You'll get your fish unless the shark gets you. If you're going to fish the bottom of it, and I think you should, one bait up top, one bait down, don't just fish one bait. No, there's no reason to. But if you're going to sit there and make drifts, let it hit the bottom. Let one of them hit the bottom. Doesn't have to be the jig. It can be, but it doesn't matter. Hit the bottom and crank it up a couple trips, okay? And the reason for that is there are stupid little coral heads and stuff like that. You don't want to, these rigs are expensive. By the time you get the lead and the hooks and all these quadruple strength hooks and stuff, this is not a cheap rig, okay? You don't want to lose them. It's like dropping a deep drop and losing that. It's expensive. What time do I like to be there? Right before dark, and right as it's getting dark, I think that's the best time. Same as the mutton spawn. Same exact same thing. I don't know why, that's how snappers are. In my opinion, two nights before the moon is the best. And that's how I've always done it. You know, if I had my druthers, I've caught them two nights before, two nights after, I've caught them on the full. But in general, if you're gonna whack them and put a bunch of them in the boat, it was always two nights before the moon. Wire, mono, it doesn't, I've done both. I used to always think, oh, it's a snapper, you gotta use mono. No, it doesn't matter. You don't really need long leaders either, because if he gets you in a wreck, you're in the wreck. You can have a 20-foot leader, you're not getting it out. It will not happen. If a shark grabs you, you're grabbed. You just write it off. It's part of the deal now. This is, you know, the Screamer wreck was one we always targeted, but in the Tortugas, every wreck has a Cubera. Every single wreck from Key West to the Tortugas has a big Cubera on it. They may not spawn there, but what's gonna catch your fish is you paying attention to, okay, if you get that bite, how are you gonna escape that area? Because if there's two boats here and one boat over there, okay, that's my out right there, you're gonna have to haul ass that way to get away, okay? You got anchor lines, and you wanna get away from that wreck fast, fast, fast. Don't worry about the other one that's down there, okay? You got one fish on, just start reeling the other one. Just reel that sucker in, don't even worry about it. They don't eat the tail first, they eat the head first. And it's like a Jewfish comes up and goes, sucks up thing. We've all seen them at the Tortugas where they just eat the bait there, that's easy. This is they're going to pulverize the bait beforehand, and they do that by crushing the skull. No, yeah, and the clicking's key, guys. That's why you want a good, fresh lobster, okay? Don't, you know, if you have to use dead ones, that's fine. I've caught them on dead ones, but you'll catch a lot more on live. Your tackle, you know, if you're using a 50-pound test, you need to be putting 20-plus pounds of pressure on this fish. And when that throttle's going down, you need to be prepared, because that's a lot of pull, guys. It's a lot of pull. These fish, it's not like a sailfish that just does his jumping. This is a digging, you know, violent, like he's just an overgrown mangrove snapper is what he is. Okay, if this is the wreck, and the current's going this way, the fish, I'd rather be fishing this area here. Okay, fish off to the side of the wreck, whatever. You don't want to drag through the wreck, you're gonna get stuck. But you always want to fish the up current side of the wreck, okay? But this is where they're spawning, and it's probably, you know, that circular motion, whatever. But they're still, I've caught them 200 yards away from the wreck. 200 yards back this way, 200 yards that way. Don't be afraid to get away from the groups. People catch them. I've caught them in the daytime right before dark, okay? I haven't even turned my lights on yet. But in general, that's about the time I want to be there, right as that transition from day to dark. Here's the good. If there's no sharks and you didn't have competition, anchoring's great. But the problem is the sharks are there, okay? I have been steamrolled by the Cuberas on that wreck. That's, you know, it's a perfect name, the Screamer, because they scream you into that wreck. If you're anchored, you're done. You don't have a prayer, okay? Unless it's a little guy. Whereas if you're drifting, now, like me personally, I'd rather drift by it, but it's just, the problem is all the stupid boats on it, you know? See, they've got a better hookup. If they're using a Bandit that has 80 pounds of pressure on it, you see what I mean? He's gonna land more fish than I am, for sure. He's not gonna lose any except the sharks. I can, you know, show you some pictures of Cuberas and stuff like that, but you know, you've all seen pictures of Cuberas. Other than the fact that it's just a tough-ass fish pound for pound, like Russell said last week, it is. It is one of the toughest fish pound for pound. Be very careful when you get it up, guys. Make no mistake, because they will bite you big time, okay? Just cut the rig off. Throw them in the fish box and let them die. Let them die. Tie up another rig. If this is 220 feet and they're, you know, you see them on your depth line easy. They're 50 feet above the wreck. Okay, so you drop it down. Okay, I think I'm at And you know, I'm pretty good at guesstimating where I am. And you put it down there and you have the guy go down next year. Hey, you go down a little bit farther and see which one. He gets a bite, maybe they're eating on the bottom part of it. I don't know, maybe they're gonna eat on the top part of it. Try it each way. But don't be afraid, guys, if you're not getting bites here, don't be afraid to drift for a quarter mile. It don't matter, then make another drift. Move over 50 yards, make another drift. You know, keep doing it, it doesn't hurt anything. There are kubaras, they don't live on this wreck. They come to this wreck. So there's, you know, they gotta get there through the highways. And just do it that way, you know, think, you know, try for it. And if you mark them, you know, elsewhere that's a quarter mile away, keep your mouth shut and catch your fish and then call your buddies and help them, you know, help them out. So, okay? Okay, guys, catch them.